Chaz Ebert is an attorney, an entrepreneur, publisher, author, and producer. She keeps the legacy of her late husband, the Pulitzer Prize-winning film critic Roger Ebert, alive by highlighting important voices in film and supporting young, emerging artists. Her latest project is the No Malice Film Contest, and she joins us now to talk all about it. Oh my goodness, Chaz, so nice to see you. It's been a while.
Micah, it's great to be here with you.
Tell me,
it has been a while.
It has been. Tell me about this film contest. This sounds so intriguing to me.
The No Malice Film Contest is something I'm doing in conjunction with the Abraham Lincoln Presidential Library Foundation. And it's open to youth Illinois residents who are from the ages of 11 to 21.
Oh.
And it's to help them. They make short films about racial healing.
I love that. And that's what we need so much right now in particular, don't we?
Absolutely. I think that last year, 2020, was stressful for all of us. But I think for young people, it was particularly stressful. And one of the ways that they can process what happened last year is through art. And I think making films is a good way to do it.
What made you come up with this? Is it just because we're in need of it right now, or it's something you think your husband would have liked, or what was the, what was the catalyst for this?
Well, the catalyst for it was the Abraham Lincoln Presidential Library Foundation, especially after the tragic killing of George Floyd. Mm-hmm. We noticed that a lot of young people were it's not just the George Floyd, but it was one of the catalysts for the program. We just thought that we wanted to bring people together. That's my mission, to help bring us together. And also for young people to be able to, I think that they're going to be our leaders, and I want to see how they think about race and allyship and equality and just bringing everybody together.
What are some of the things you've seen already? Because I'm sure you've already gotten some entries, haven't you?
Well, the interesting thing, our contest is only open to Illinois residents. We've probably gotten 50 entries from around the world.
Oh my goodness.
Yes.
So and are you going to open it up maybe, or what do you think?
I wish we could. I don't think that we can change the rules in the middle of the contest.
Right, right.
But it made me think we may do something with some of the other entries after this official contest is over.
It just shows that there's such a need right now for people to express themselves in so many ways. And film, I mean, what better way than through film?
Roger said that movies are an empathy machine, and to help put us in someone else's shoes and let us know what it feels like to be a person of a different race or age or gender or ethnicity. I think that filmmaking, especially with young people at this time, is so important.
Will we be able to see it as a public, some of these entries or some of the winners? How do we take a look?
Okay, I'm so excited to tell you this, Micah. We're going to have a red carpet debut for the filmmakers.
Okay.
At Ebert Fest Film Festival down in Champaign-Urbana. But we will also make the films available. The winning films will be available to throughout the Chicago public school system. We're going to make them available. And we're also, there's something else that we're thinking about doing in Chicago to open it up to the public, but that's not completely set in stone.
It's still hush hush. You don't have to say anything yet. But let me ask you this. You're still having the film festival in the midst of COVID, or do you think it's opening up enough and more people are being vaccinated?
I'm fully vaccinated, and so are some of the people who are working on Ebert Fest. I hope that more people go. I have to be honest with you, I'm still trying to convince more people, people very close to me, to get vaccinated, but more and more people are getting vaccinated. It feels like freedom, like a weight has been lifted from my shoulders. And so we are actually reaching out to people who are vaccinated for the film festival.
Wonderful.
So we're going to have it in person in September, September 8th through 11th.
Sounds great. Congratulations, Chaz, and be safe and be well, okay?
Thank you so much.
Nice to see you. It's always great
to see you.
Same here. The deadline to enter is May 31st. You can find more details at RogerEbert.com.